He was supposed to show up around 12. I was already waiting for him at the elevators, dressed as a cleaner. Finally, Chris appeared at the entrance. Immediately, I put the mop in the cart and quickly followed him. Chris Sparks was a controversial photographer, and he dug up dirt on my boyfriend Ben. I had to steal the flash drive with the pictures right out of his pocket. I was almost at his side when the big guard called out to me. "Stop!" I pretended not to hear and quickened my pace. But the guard grabbed me by the elbow and abruptly blurted out, "I told you to wipe it here!" I tried to pull away. I couldn't let Chris go, but the guard made it clear that it was pointless to argue. I grabbed him up and quickly wiped away the stain. The guard turned away, pleased with himself, and I saw Chris step inside the elevator. The doors were slowly closing behind him. Damn, I'm missing him. Then I kicked the cart as hard as I could. It slammed the elevator and immediately blocked the doors. The noise made everyone in the hall stare at me. Oh, I'm so clumsy. Sorry. I quickly pushed the cart into the elevator and pressed the button for the top floor. I only had 15 seconds to get the dirt from Sparks. The doors closed. The game began. The stakes were high. Tomorrow, my boyfriend Ben was going to participate in the final stage of the mayoral election, for which he had been preparing for a whole year, and I helped him. If Chris handed over the flash drive with the dirt in the hands of journalists, Ben would lose. And here I was, disguised as a cleaning lady, standing in the elevator next to Chris. I did everything according to plan. I took out the glass cleaner and began to wipe the mirror. Then I deliberately sprayed on some Chris's jacket. "I'm sorry, I'm so clumsy. The jacket needs to be washed urgently, otherwise the liquid will corrode the wool." Before Chris knew it, I'd already taken off his jacket and was ostensibly scrubbing at the stain. In fact, I definitely reached into the inside pocket of his jacket. We knew that Chris carried important things there. But there was nothing inside. Where was the flash drive? At the moment, Chris thanked me, took his jacket, and turned to the mirror in the elevator to adjust it. Then I saw him put something small in his back pocket. So he was holding the flash drive in his hands all this time. I looked at the panel. We had almost reached the top floor. There wasn't much time left. So I took a couple of steps toward Chris. Sure, getting the flash drive out of his hands was a lot harder, but I had to try. I was standing right next to him. Suddenly, the light flickered. The cabin jerked and the elevator braked sharply. I swayed, got thrown off, and bumped my forehead lightly against the stupid cart. This was my chance. I pretended to hit myself hard and asked Chris to get me some water. He became nervous, turned to the cart, and started looking for the bottle. At this time, I reached into the back pocket of his pants and found the keychain, which apparently was attached to the flash drive. I grabbed it and pulled gently. That's it! Almost got it. Then Chris turned around. He was holding a bottle of water. I jerked my hand away and pretended I wasn't thinking straight. The damn flash drive was still in his pocket! Chris said that he needed to call a doctor soon and immediately reached for the call button for the dispatcher. Not that! If the elevator went, I wouldn't have time to pick up the flash drive. I immediately grabbed Chris by the shirt, pulled him to me, and not knowing what else to do, tried to kiss him. "I'm sorry, Ben, but this is all for you." As I reached out to kiss Chris, I reached into his pocket with a flash drive. A second later, I had the flash drive in my hand. Yes! But Chris pulled back so abruptly that he knocked the flash drive out of my hand. It hit the metal floor with a crash. I tried to push the flash drive under the cart with my foot, but Chris had already looked down and was clutching at the pocket of his pants. He said he had just dropped a very important item. I politely offered to help with the search. But Chris quickly saw the flash drive and put it back in his pants pocket. And then he looked me straight in the eye and said that even though his vision was -7, he immediately saw a striking resemblance between me and the mayor's girlfriend, Lila. And she also passionately hugged in public with her boyfriend, Ben. My heart sank with fear. Did he see through me? Trying not to show my excitement, I replied coldly that I had no idea who this Lila was. Chris said that he would love to tell such a beauty about politics. But now was not the time and place. But he was in a hurry to work. He reached for the call button again. No, you're not leaving here until I get the flash drive. I tried to kiss him again, but this time he politely pushed me away. Am I not good enough for you, mister? Chris said that unlike Ben Hayes, the controversial mayoral candidate, he didn't kiss girls he didn't know. What do you mean? Chris grimaced and reluctantly told me that Ben had been caught with a mulatto woman this weekend. He gave her flowers and they went somewhere holding hands. And his girlfriend Lila probably didn't know what he was doing. My heart sank in pain. No, Ben's not like that. He couldn't do this to me. I was at a loss, and Chris managed to press the button to call the dispatcher. Oh no. Chris said that we were stuck, and the speaker said that the elevator would go in a minute. There was no time to make a mistake, so we started counting down the seconds in my head. Chris suddenly took off his glasses and began to wipe them. Yes, -7. He couldn't see anything without his glasses. I pushed the cart hard and it hit Chris right on the elbow. The glasses fell out and flew somewhere on the floor. Damn. I'm sorry, that stupid cart had a broken wheel a long time ago. Chris looked at me with displeasure and began to search for his glasses. I finally managed to grab the keychain, pull the flash drive out of his pocket, and clench it tightly in my fist. It worked! Chris wanted to let me go first out of the elevator, but I told him I was on the wrong floor, and went back down. As soon as I left the building, I hailed a taxi. Within 15 minutes, I was at Ben's headquarters. Ben! I got the damn flash drive! We're safe! He grabbed it greedily from my hand and hugged me so tightly for the first time in his life. But after a couple of minutes, he looked back at his smartphone and said he had a lot to do. A lump of resentment rose in my throat. Can't you see I miss you, Ben? But he said he had an important meeting scheduled for the evening with a female government politician. Congresswoman Ben. I remembered what Chris had said about Ben having someone else. Ben, what's on this flash drive? You still haven't told me what dirt they found. He hesitated in a strange way and began to mumble that there were documents and I would not understand anything in them. I realized he'd been lying to me all along. I snatched the flash drive out of Ben's hand and headed for the nearest laptop. Ben tried to stop me, but I pinned his foot down with all my strength. Let's see what you're hiding from me, my love. Ben ran over to me, but I had already opened the flash drive on the laptop. But instead of documents or photos of Ben's, there were only pictures of Chris in a dinosaur costume. What the hell? In each photo, Chris held a sign with a letter on it. I read everything and they lined up in the phrase, "Don't trust anyone." At the same time, our press secretary called me and asked me to open the news immediately. Ben's phone was ringing too. I immediately opened the news portal and browser. On the front page, my love was hugging a mulatto woman in a restaurant. At the bottom of the article was the postscript. The photos arrived at a publishing house around 7 a.m. So Chris passed on the dirt before we met in the elevator. Ben started to tell me that this was a Photoshop. That I did not understand. And indeed, I had myself to blame. I slapped him hard and left. I was choking with resentment and pain. What a fool I was. Ben didn't love me. I was just a convenient beauty who fulfilled all his whims. Then I got a text from Chris. He asked me out on a date. Since I was free now, how did he get my number? I didn't want to know though. After today, all I wanted to do was get drunk. I'll meet you at the bar, Chris. I'll tell you a lot more about Ben and his dirty tricks.
Yo, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel. Be careful with your imagination and have a good day.